Welcome to the Assassin Meta of Brawl Stars. We have never had a meta like this in Brawl Stars, so there's a lot to talk about. And as always, guys, I'm going to be the first to give you an in-depth look at the Brawl Stars meta, including the brawlers that are best and worst with this pro-rated brawler tier list. Hope you enjoy. Hello, fellow brawlers, I'm KairosTime, and it is time to brawl. We're also going to be taking a look at this tier list today. And before we jump into this, I want to remind you that I actually do this updated series with every single balance change. This is version 9 of the Brawl Stars tier list, so make sure you stick around for future updates to it. Also, make sure you stick around for the end of the video for the overall tier list that includes everything put into one nice little organized picture for you. Over here is the current tier list for Gem Grab. I'll pause for just one moment while you take a screenshot. Okay, now let's move on. That's right, guys. Daryl is moving from the A tier up into the S tier, taking Pam's spot for the golden S tier position. Once again, the golden S tier is reserved for the single brawler that the pros that helped coordinate with this tier list consider to be the best for that game mode. And Daryl definitely deserves it. In fact, he is the golden S tier brawler for 3 of the tier list in today's video. The buff to his attack, and especially to his star power, allows him to win almost every single 1v1 interaction in the game, and the fact that his super automatically loads actually poses a massive threat to the enemy gem carrier. Poco is also moving from the A tier up into the S tier because of his star power buff. This gives him incredible versatility in being able to decide whether it's actually worth it for him to attack the enemy player with his very low damage per second, or heal teammates that can be closer to him with a much bigger heal than he used to have. This is actually allowing more tanky brawlers that are a little bit more aggressive, like Daryl or even Mortis, to combo with Poco, making them incredibly strong. Speaking of Mortis, he's also moving up into the S tier from the B tier, where the increase to his attack and star power buff truly made Mortis the Immortus. That's right. He's now called the Immortus. TM, his kills now snowball into complete domination, making him an excellent option for Gem Grab. Jessie is moving from the S tier down into the A tier. She has less damage per second than Pam, and she's less versatile than Poco, though she still can actually be used, especially because of some of these more aggressive brawlers, you know, like Mortis, do tend to struggle against her. She's just a little bit more off meta. Terra is also moving from the S tier down into the A tier. This fast-paced meta that makes her slow building super, kind of a little bit of a liability. It still can be incredibly good at turning the tide of battle, but there are other brawlers that are a little bit better at doing that, like Mortis and Daryl. A lot of the time, she actually has to end up using her super on those tankier brawlers just to take them out, rather than on the enemy gem carrier like she would prefer to do. Bo is moving up into the A tier with increased damage to help with finishing off enemy brawlers. Now, despite the fact that his star power was actually nerfed, he's actually seeing a little bit more usability on more maps, despite being more vulnerable on maps that have more bushes, like Stone Fort. Rico is moving up from the B tier into the A tier because of the increased damage output that allows him to actually offer more control than he did before. Brock and Barley are both moving from the A tier down to the B tier. A lot of it has to deal with the fact that they're a little bit vulnerable to those assassin type of brawlers like Daryl and Mortis, and Barley's rework to his super especially makes him vulnerable to those brawlers at close ranges. El Primo and Bull are also being removed from the competitive tier list due to there being better tanky options like Daryl and Mortis, and the possibility of Rico and Spike being more viable makes it difficult for them to navigate the field to charge their super. El Primo and Bull are both being removed from the B tier because there are just better melee options like Daryl and Mortis, and also the fact that Rico and Spike make it very difficult for them to actually navigate the field in order for them to initially charge up their supers. Up next, we have Solo Showdown, and as you can see, we've got a few brawlers that are moving up into the rankings. I think it's pretty obvious why Daryl is actually moving up into the S tier. His recent buffs just made him very strong and allows him to actually take advantage of ambushing isolated brawlers. Also, we have Bull, who's moving up because of the nerf to Bo's star power, where Bull initially struggled a little bit on those maps that have lots of bushes. Now he is more viable, where Bo is a little bit less frequently used. Mortis is moving from the B tier up into the A tier due to his increased damage, which allows him to win some more 1v1 situations, and of course his mobility does allow him to avoid confrontation. He's also one of the best brawlers as a counter to teaming brawlers such as Dynamite and Barley. Rico's becoming a little bit more viable coming up into the the B tier, now where he does a little bit more damage, thus allowing him to actually take out brawlers that do approach on him despite his low survivability. And you can also use Frank a little bit more on some of those maps that do allow him to zone enemies away with his super that is, once again, very easy to charge up. Up next, we've got Duo Showdown, where a few brawlers are moving up and a few are moving down. Daryl, once again, moving up into the S tier. He's, if you haven't noticed so far, he's very strong. Mortis is also moving up into the S tier. He's very powerful against those low health brawlers, especially with his extended life and ability to support his ally brawlers. He's really good at getting that finishing kill where he is then able to immediately heal a bunch with his star power. And even using his super makes him a very strong option in Duo Showdown. And the fact that he can away from enemy brawlers in those tricky situations when you're waiting for your teammate to respawn does make him a very solid option. Bo's moving up into the A tier because of his increased damage output, which makes him a little bit more of a threat. Even though his sight is decreased with his star power, it is sufficient to make him a viable option. Jessie's moving down from the B tier because her super really just doesn't actually help with increasing that much damage. Typically, a lot of times people just target really quickly and take it out. Rico's recent buff does make him a little bit more reliable in Duo Showdown, especially on a few specific maps that have lots of walls. And Tara is being moved to the non-ranked position simply because she's just not very good against this aggressive meta due to her low health and slow to charge super. She just doesn't deal enough damage to deal with those brawlers like Mortis and Daryl. And up next, guys, we've got Heist, where we have tons of changes due to the recent changes that the maps have actually seen for Heist. Now, Daryl used to be the king in Heist, but when his super range was decreased by so much, he actually kind of gave Bull that spot. But with his recent buffs and the fact that the walls around the safe were actually removed, Daryl is now able to easily charge up his super and roll in onto the safe, once again making him the king of Heist. Colt's moving up into the S tier because now he doesn't even need his super to actually blast his way through and deal a ton of damage to the enemy safe because the walls are just removed. Not to mention the fact that the maps now tend to favor some of these long-range shooters that Colt can do a really good job against. Both Barley and Dynamike are being moved from the S tier down into the A tier. Now, both of them do struggle a little bit more due to the fact that there are less walls on a lot of these heist maps, and that makes them both a lot more vulnerable. Also, we have Barley, whose super is no longer able to completely stack onto a safe, allowing him to deal insane amounts of damage to the safe with one super. Leon's moving down into the A tier because his damage nerf just made him less viable. And Pam is moving from the B up into the A tier for a couple different reasons. First of all, the fact that there are no walls around the safes allows her to become an immediate threat from a very decent range. And she also pairs very well with Bull and Daryl, both of which are very tanky and who are also very strong in this meta. The fact that the health from the safes were actually buffed by 20% means that it takes a lot more to actually shred through those safes, which means that Pam, especially if she can get up close, can really help out with that. Poco's moving from non-ranked up into the A tier because of his ability to now support brawlers that are a little bit more aggressive. So we have Bull and Daryl, and he can actually help heal them from a distance, even though he doesn't do a ton of damage to the safe himself. And then we have Rico, who is non-ranked and is now going to the A tier because of his ability to attack the safe from a very long distance away. Crow is moving from the A tier up into the B tier. He's just less impactful against these tankier brawlers with healers that are basically a very solid counter against Crow. We also have El Primo moving from the A tier down into the B tier with these more open maps that make it more difficult for him to actually get to the safe, especially with these long-range brawlers that can just take him out from a distance. And then also surprisingly, we have Piper moving from the non-ranked up into the B tier, where these maps are a lot more open. She can actually get some shots off on the safe from a distance where nobody else can reach her range except for Brock and maybe Rico. Though she's not quite as versatile as a brawler like Brock is because of her lack of defensive ability. Nita is moving down from the B tier into the non-ranked category because the maps are more open. That just makes it more difficult for her to actually charge up a bear and get close to the enemy safe. Up next, we've got some Brawl Ball changes, as you can see right over here. Grab that screenshot. They go by fast. Guys, Daryl, he kicks, he rolls, he shoots. He's just amazing in Brawl Ball. Where defensive gameplay is very strong in Brawl Ball at the moment, Daryl is one of the brawlers that's actually able to go on the offense while minimizing the amount of damage that he has. Not to mention the fact that he's kind of like replaced Mortis in his ability to actually self-pass the ball, makes him just an incredibly strong brawler in Brawl Ball, especially if you do have the skill to pull him off. Nita's moving from the A tier up into the S tier because she's just such a great buffer in any comp. Her bear allows her and her teammates to actually push up because it eats enemy ammo, applies a little bit of pressure, and is even more threatening after her recent star power buff. Jessie's moving from the A tier up into the S tier. Once again, her turret does require hits from the enemy players, so that does waste their ammo and allows your team to push up a little bit. It also offers a lot of control against brawlers that are a little bit more short range, like Daryl tends to thrive a lot on Brawl Ball, and she's a good counter against him. And her star power is just incredible at getting rid of the enemy's ammo, which, like I said, creates that opportunity for your team to actually get a Brawl Ball into the goal. Leon is moving from the S tier down to the A tier. Not only did he get that nerf, but with the changes to Brawl Ball where it actually takes up your ammunition, he has a very slow reload speed, so that actually impacts him more than it does some of these other brawlers. El Primo is moving down into the A tier because of map dependency, and also he just gets shut down a little bit more by ranged comps, and Daryl just kind of like outshines him in a lot of different ways. And Poco is moving from the B tier up into the A tier because of his ability to support tankier brawlers like Daryl and Nita, where his star power can actually help him offer a little bit more of that offensive push by once again healing his teammates. Rico's moving from non-ranked up into the A tier because of his increased damage and ability to outrange enemy brawlers on those more open maps. And Mortis is moving from the A tier down into the B tier. The old king of Brawl Ball is no longer the king, where his ability to self-pass the ball is greatly hindered by the fact that shooting the ball actually takes up an ammo. Brock is moving from the B tier down into the non-ranked tier because he's just too vulnerable against those brawlers that have a lot of more like aggression, like once again Daryl, and he really struggles with the ball due to the fact that he has such a slow reload speed. Shooting that ball or kicking it really hits Brock very hard. And then of course, once again, the fact that his reload speed is so low makes it so that kicking the ball is a very big nerf to Brock's viability on Brawl Ball. And here we've got the bounty tier list, which is by far the most different bounty tier list that we have ever seen before. Mortis, guys. Okay, now there's two reasons why Mortis is so strong in bounty right now. The first is the fact that he got those recent buffs, and the second is a lot of the maps that have been changed in bounty now offer a little bit more viability. Previously, they used to very much favor those long-range brawlers, but now there's a lot of walls that allow Mortis to really get close up on those enemy brawlers, and that allows him to really do well against some of those brawlers that are a little bit more squishy, like Piper. Daryl's moving from the A tier up into the S tier for basically the same reasons, and because he's just OP right now. Honestly, I cannot believe that Piper is moving from the S tier down to the A tier. She used to be the queen of bounty, and even when I gave Brock the golden S tier position for the first time in the last tier list, I think that it very well could have been argued that she could have had that position as the best brawler for bounty. The new maps just don't favor her as much, and she is highly susceptible to damage from those assassin type brawlers like Mortis, Leon, and Daryl. She's still a great option, just not the obvious choice that she used to be in the previous meta. Penny is in almost the exact same situation as Piper is, where she's still a good option, just not as good as she used to be because of the changes to the maps and the new assassin like brawlers just dominating the field. Pam and Poco are both moving up into the A tier because of their ability to support those assassin type brawlers while also being great counters against them. Dynamite and Barley are just straight up being removed from the bounty tier list, even though they may be viable on one of the maps. They're just too vulnerable to those assassin type brawlers to really be able to survive, especially with Barley's super rework. Lastly, guys, we have the overall tier list. Now, I'm not going to talk about every single change for every single brawler, but there were a few brawlers that I did want to mention that have changed significantly since version 8 of the tier list. First of all, is Daryl. We've already talked about Daryl a lot. He is the second brawler ever to have a perfect 18 out of 18 score. Before his buff, he was actually 10 out of 18, and the last brawler to have a perfect score was actually Leon on the last tier list. Now is definitely the time to push Daryl because I imagine he's going to get nerfed. I don't think that he is as strong as Leon was when he was 18 out of 18, but he still is very arguably the strongest brawler in the game because of his ability to be versatile in every single game mode in the game. Mortis's changes have made him way more versatile than before, despite him being less of an option in Brawl Ball. He's moving from 7 points up into 12 points, and he is becoming less of a specialist and much more of just like a fun assassin brawler to play. Rico is moving from the lowest ranking brawler up from 3 points to 10 points. Honestly, I'm surprised that the damage buff was actually enough to make Rico very viable. I really did think that he was going to need a little bit more range or wider shots, but hey, I'll take it. Poco is moving from 4 points up to 10 points. This has two reasons. The first is the fact that he got a buff to his star power, and the second is the fact that the meta now favors a Poco due to his ability to support those assassin type brawlers, especially from a distance on the enemy side of the field, which is something that Pam struggled to do with. Terra is notably moving from 9 points down to 6 points, where more brawlers are becoming more of a viable option in the game. Terra's underwhelming stats have made her less of an option, despite the fact that she has such an incredible super. A lot of this also has to deal with the fact that these assassin type brawlers do a good job at countering her and force her to use her super on them rather than on the targets that she really wants to. Barley's also moving from 9 points down to 6 points, partly due to the fact that the buff to Mortis actually counters him very hard, but also due to the fact that his super rework has made him less of a viable option in close combat. Generally, more brawlers are becoming more viable in more game modes, and I think part of this is the way that Supercell is actually doing their balance changes, but another very big part of it is the way that they're actually adding a lot more different types of maps to game modes that tended to have very specific meta comps in them. In particular, Heist and Bounty in the most recent update. And of course, guys, I wanted to give a huge thank you to the incredibly skilled players that helped with the making of this tier list. Z, United, The Secret, Super Bram, Skunk Seaman, Shadow Jutsu, Real Canadian, Portal, Olive Oil, Lukey Bear, LOL, Little Fox, Keenan, Jeff, Illustria, Ed, TM, Cradu, and Corey. A big thank you to them, and a special thank you to my YouTube members and my Patreon sponsors for helping support my channel in such a big way. For now, this is KairosTime ticking by, and we will see you in the assassin meta of Brawl Stars.